I just want to, first of all, apologize to the victim in this case for my role in what was a very devastating invasion of privacy that no one should have to go through. I want to apologize, as I have many times throughout this process, to our community for the disappointment that I have brought to them, to my family and friends for the embarrassment that I have caused. I want to express my appreciation to everyone who has been involved in handling this case, especially the Lenawee County Prosecutor's Office, as well as offer an apology to the Prosecutor's Office, especially Mr. Castleberry and Angie Borders, for anything that I have done throughout this process that has made their job more difficult. And I would just ask the board for an opportunity to continue to live a productive and meaningful life in which I can contribute to the world around me.
Thank you. Mr. Daly.
Mayor, we believe that the pre-sentence report in this matter is a fair and accurate report. I'm aware that the court has also received some negative letters as it relates to Mr. Stevens that we believe are primarily without merit, and we would challenge the accuracy of some of those letters if it became a part of this. But the important thing, Your Honor, is that at 23 years of age, he didn't have a spot on his record until this happened. In the pre-sentence report, he says he has an alcoholic drink every other night. I'm not sure that's true. I can remember being 23 years old, and if you're a drinker, you're not going to be drinking every other night. And in this particular case, and when he first received some of those images, he had been drinking, which is not an excuse for anything, but drinking does color your judgment. At the very least, his judgment was non-existent at that particular time. But what he has done right now is his life has been destroyed as he knows it. He's been very active in the community, but for the circumstances that he's in right now, he would at this time be actively involved in a statewide political campaign. So his life, at least for 15 years, is going to have some substantial changes. He's going to have to be reflecting on what went wrong and how it went wrong and to make sure that that never happens again. He wants to continue to have a life. He wants to continue to serve the community. And none of those things are possible right now. The community is not going to want to engage with him politically in any manner whatsoever, certainly while he is on the list and while he's on probation. He understands that, he's going to accept that, and he wants to spend the next few years concentrating on completing his education and moving forward and trying to put this behind him. He also knows about the effect that this is going to have on social media, as he had always been a very active participant in social media. Now he works at Macy's, and he has contact there with a computer that goes to the internet, but it's not a social media thing. He is only in contact with vendors. Every keystroke is monitored by Macy's, and I think if it becomes necessary, we could get a license to that extent to show that this is not a case where he could get on the internet and engage in chat room conversations with anybody. That just can't happen now. But he's working there, and he wants to continue working. The good thing about this, if there's any good at all, is that he's only 23 years old, and he has an opportunity to rebuild his life. But his life is going to have to be rebuilt. And I think court, probation, and everybody is on his side to the extent they want to see him ultimately be successful. And he wants to be successful. And he will do whatever he can to convince this court that he has learned from this and that he wants to continue to be a productive citizen. I'd be very surprised if this court ever sees a repeat of any type of behavior on the part of Mr. Stevens. And we would ask you to take those things into consideration in passing sentence.
Judge, the only comment I would have is this. While Mr. Stevens' apologies to Mr. Castleberry and his orders, I hear them. They did their job. He pled as charged. Those apologies should be safe for the people that were depicted in his photographs. And with that, I give the court's discretion.
Thank you. Stevens, Mr. Daley, anything else?
I have nothing, Your Honor.
Devin Tyler Stevens, determining the appropriate sentence in this case, court has considered the seriousness of the offense, your history, the principles of proportionality, statutory penalty, and the cost of confinement. The sentencing guidelines, the report, and recommendation of the probation department. And I have heard what has been said upon this record at this hearing, as well as the other, the letters that I've disclosed. The criteria reads for the sentence on the nature and gravity of offenses, the discipline appropriate to their commission, deterrence against repetition by you as well as by others, potential for reformation, vindication for the law, and the protection of society. It is not against the law to be who you are and have the rights as they come to every citizen. How you influence those rights with alcohol is your individual choice. You crossed the line and you broke the law. There's no doubt in my mind that you know that and that you understand it. And that this has been a horrible experience. But unfortunately, that's not very unique for everybody who stands before me in this position and every court in the land. It's intended to be a horrible experience. It is not intended to dehumanize or to belittle you or to contribute to the destroying of your life. Only you have the power to destroy your life. As far as the political climate, that's about as unpredictable as the weather. You still have to be who you are, but you may not be who you are within a criminal community without expecting consequences. I am convinced that although your behavior was of a very personal nature, and that you have lost a job, lost a political position, you may have lost some leverage in those communities, employment and political strength, such is that of public figures. My job today is to make sure that you understand, we understand what you did was wrong. And I want to know that you understand it sufficiently to never engage again, not in who you are, but in criminal behavior. I had to look very closely and very hard at the consequences, especially with regard to mandatory filing as a sex offender for a period of 15 years. I cannot avoid that consequence. I know that you asked for it. I know that many of the people who supported you asked for it. But I am not convinced that those people know everything that has come to light, or that I know everything that has resulted in this criminal charge. But I know you do, and I'm entrusting you to make sure that that never happens and that you never appear in front of this court or violate another law been ordering you to be placed on 5 years probation. You must pay $750 in court costs, $130 crime victim rights fee. There's a $68 state cost and a $60 DNA fee. You will pay $12.50 per month supervision fee. You are ordered to remain active on the Michigan Sex Offender Registry for 15 years. No contact with children under the age of 17. And you are not to be in possession or use any device that is capable of connecting to the internet, including computers and cell phones, excepting therefrom the computer use at your job at Macy's.
Judge, we would like to, if that's going to be acceptable, that we require a written letter from Macy's stating that you will not be able to be on other sites except when they allow for work.
Does your work know that you're...
They are not aware of the situation, but if that is necessary, we can have that conversation. I would prefer not to have that conversation.
I understand. Well, I want to be certain that everybody knows that that computer is not going to be used for anything but work.
Your Honor, I can tell you that it is impossible to access sites on that computer outside of Macy's internal website. Anything not related to our company or our vendors is completely blocked.
Well, I've made the mistake of depending on that in the past.
I understand.
And I just think they're far more invasive and capable than we can ever dream of. I would like to have you have Macy's confirm that that computer is only for employment purposes and that you are not using that computer for any other, that you do not have access for use of that computer for any other personal use. And that should be sufficient.
And any further employer in the future?
Well, any further employer is going to be reported to probation, and that will be continued to be the order. So you have no permission beyond Macy's, so you'll have to get that. But your relationship with your probation agent should be one of constant exchange of information and communication. If I were on probation, that's what I would do. So they're not ever saying they didn't see me enough. They're saying they saw me too much. And if you're smart, and I do believe you are an intellectual person, then you'll see your way through that. And I am going to order you to serve 90 days in Illinois County Jail, and I am deferring that until the end of your probation. Mr. Stevens, I got to tell you, I guess you could have a pop or a flip phone. There are flip phones that you can't do anything with.
There are.
Right. And I know that. But anything you have, you ought to have approved by probation way before you get it hooked up. I'm not unaware of that need, but I am telling you right now, a lot of people violate in this area with the electronics. If you took my phone away tomorrow, I would be lost. So I'm telling you, I understand, but you must remain diligent. Do not do this. It could result in you looking at a 4-year sentence, and that has happened. And so I'm really speaking from experience and cautioning you. I don't want to violate you. I don't want to sentence you on a violation. But they will. So don't do it. And let's just put this in a chapter in your book of life that stinks, that was horrible, and that with behavior change, you'll overcome this. That would be my hope. This is a crime. And I have to treat it as such. You do have the right to appeal the sentence and conviction. You do that by seeking application for leave to appeal or appeal by right. either way, if you want to appeal, you want to turn it, but you can't afford one, I would put one for you at public expense. The request for the appointment of an attorney must be made in writing, sent to the address on these papers, and you only have 42 days to do that. And then you have to fill out the bottom, which is like a financial form. We ask you to sign one and keep two for your own records.
Judge, as part of the court sentence, the remaining terms listed in paragraphs 1 through 9 are also imposed, is that correct?
That's correct.
Thank you.
All the terms of probation will be gone over with you one by one in the probation department. And I would ask you to check into the probation department this morning before you leave the building. If you'll do that. And my other best advice is that you keep in close communication. It's not what you want to do, but it would be a good place for you to start towards being successful in turning this over. A lot of people overcome this, a lot of people go to prison. You get to write that chapter.
I have no intention of standing here again.
Thank you.
Thank you, Your Honor.